So you maybe heard that in your first calculus course that there is always at least two places on the Earth that is on the opposite sides where the temperature is the same. And this can actually be proven by one of the theorems that you learn in your first calculus course, which is called the mean value theorem, often called MVT. So how can you prove this? This probably sounds a little bit like magic, but if you just draw the temperature as a continuous function around the Earth, let's just assume that's along the equator, then you see this has to be true, and I'm gonna prove it. Okay, so you start drawing the Earth. Okay, you call this position 0, you call this position
pi over 2,
you call this position pi, and you call this position
3 pi over 2,
and you call this position, which is the same as the 0, that's 2 pi. So, you know that 0 and 2 pi is the same because it's the exact same position in the circle. You just take one turn. And you know that sinus to 0 is the same as sinus to 2 pi. And the sine and the cosine of 0 is the same as cosine as 2 pi. So that's the same position. So if you draw, if you just take some random temperature, say it's 0 degrees Celsius here and 10 degrees Celsius here. So what you see here is that on this position and this position is on the exact same opposite sides of the Earth, but the temperature is not the same. But somewhere along the way here, between these two positions, the temperature has to be the exact same and the exact opposite sides of the Earth. So if I just draw this as a continuous function, here's my temperature axis, and that's the position axis. So let's start here in the position 0 here, and then let's call this position the pi here, and this position 2 pi. And I know that the temperature right here, let's just draw a line here, an arrow. So here on the position 0, the temperature is 0, so I put a point here. But the temperature is also the same as here, in 2 pi. And here I know it's 10. So I have to make a point right here. And I can just draw a random line. It can be, say it goes like this. That's the temperature between here and here. Between here and here. That's given by this curve, and then I have to draw a curve that goes down here. Let's say it's just like this. So what I see here is that this position and this position is on the exact opposite sides of the Earth, and this, if I just go a random length of position out here, let's call that delta, and I take the same length over here and call this delta, then the position 0 plus delta is on the opposite side of pi plus delta. You see here that no matter how much you move, if you move the same length from 0 and pi, then you will always be on the opposite sides of the Earth. And in some place along that line, you will see that that the temperature is the exact same and it's the opposite sides of the Earth. So if you see here, this looks like on the that it is on the opposite sides of the Earth and that the temperature is same. But an easier way to see that this is true, if you draw a line, it's easier to see if you draw a line here where you take the position from 0 to pi, which you have right here. So I'm gonna draw it like this. And it goes up, down, up, down, up, down. And then I know that from, if I take any position that is the same length from 0 as from pi, then it is on opposite sides of the Earth. So if I start my curve on 10 right here, then I know that the temperature right here and here are on the opposite sides of the Earth. And if I just draw this function down to so you can imagine that the interval from 0 to pi is represented by this curve, and the interval from pi to 2 pi is represented by this curve right here, which I will draw in the same diagram. So what do we see here? That right here, the temperature is the exact same, let's just call it X, and it's the exact opposite sides of the Earth. So why is that? As I tried to explain earlier, that 0 and 2 pi is in the same position. So if I just take this continuous function and put it over here, then you see that this. So if I use this one, you see that 0 and pi is on the opposite sides of the Earth, and as you go around the Earth here, the same length, it will always be on opposite sides of the Earth. So that's what I've done down here. I moved the same length from the 0 and the pi position. This position right here is, let's call that, it's delta from 0, but it's also delta from pi, represented by this curve. So this position is delta from 0 right here, and this position is delta from pi right here. And to see that they are on opposite sides of Earth, of the Earth, I just draw the line which represents the exact opposite sides of Earth. So all these points here are on the exact opposite sides of the Earth. And in some place they have to cross in order for this line or this curve to make it from up here to down there, because these two points have to be on the same height and these two points have to be on the same height. As you can see here, that's 10 and that's 10 right there, and 10 right there. And that's 0 and 0 degrees. And that's 0 right here and 0 right there. Thanks for watching. I hope this helped you. If you have any video suggestions, just put it in the comment section below. And I hope you see you in the next one.